So basically, this is a movie, the found footage genre has been sort of used a lot for horror recently, and for the, this is basically parahormonal activity. How was shooting a found footage movie? I mean, did you guys get to hold the camera at times? Did you get involved in that stuff? Did you do any of that kind of fun stuff?
Not really. I know they handed out a little flip cams to some of the extras just so we can get different angles on stuff. Because nowadays, like, everyone's got some sort of video recording device on them at all times, so it's, you know, believable that we would get all these different angles at this party. Yeah. I know Dax was the one, you know, that was supposed to be shooting it, and I think there were only a couple times where he was actually holding the camera, but mostly it was our cinematographer, Ken Tsang.
Gotcha. If I would have been holding the camera, it would have been terrible, so yeah. I don't know how that works.
Well, there's one scene, like the Kirby scene by the pool, where we're shooting on a flip cam, and so it was Ken just kind of behind me, like guiding my hand while I'm trying to act at the same time.
Right.
Yeah.
I think this movie defies a lot of the found footage conventions that are so popular, because it's stylized, Neo has a great eye, it has music, a lot of found footage movies have askew music. It doesn't feel like it's just some kid picked up a camera and filmed it. It feels like even though there's the found footage element and there's Dax, it still feel like it's a slick movie. You still feel like you're watching an awesome, crazy party experience.
I think it's got more style than any other found footage movie. I mean, it's got a lot of style for any movie, just period. Yeah. It's really stylized.
No shakiness every 5 seconds. Yeah. There's no every 5 seconds, no one goes, why are you filming? Why are you filming?
Yeah.
Which is a nice touch.
Obviously, you guys have got to be friends for, you know, several years in the movie, so did they give you a chance to actually develop any kind of relationship before you started shooting? Did they send you out to get drunk together?
3 weeks.
Disneyland.
Sort of, yeah. We went to Disneyland. We took a weekend and went up to Big Bear. Just a lot of play dates to bond over.
We still, like, hang out all the time.
Yeah, we kind of, we are friends.
We became
and
good friends.
We had, like, we all had the same thing in common, where this was like a big thing for all of us, rather than we were all like movie stars going into, you know, going into just another project. For us, this was like, this could be a big thing for all of us. So we had that all in common. That's easy to become friends.
It was like fresh and exciting and new for all of us. Yeah. You know, if one of us had been an established actor, just the dynamic wouldn't have been the same.
Yeah.
And we like each other.
Yeah.
So let's not go that far.
we don't like.
It's all fake in reality. You know, you get outside and you're fighting basically, and you're just punching each other. So.
Yeah. God, no.
was there any method drinking involved? You know, were you sort of like, well, I've got to imagine that I get slightly wasted at this party, so I better go out.
I can't speak for the extras, but
chugged old duels like no other.
Yeah, we did
non-alcoholic
beer for
Kecksters.
I mean, I guess at the same time you were working as well as, you know, having fun.
I felt like I was drunk half the time. You're just running around screaming like
it's 5 a.m. and there's stuff on fire.
It was just a mixture of like an exhaustion, but then adrenaline too. It was just
half the time, really cool. Fake being drunk anyways when I'm at a party, you know.
It's true. So.
No, it's quite sensible. It's a good
one
idea.
One thing
right?
I do sometimes I like ask for a Diet Coke, but in like the drink glass at a bar.
Yeah.
Sensible.
To fit in.
Yeah.
That's good.
That's good.
Yeah, it was very important to for us to try and keep our energy up the whole time. So we're constantly trying to match the energy of the party, you know, which is
fortunate.
Hard to do for 5 weeks straight, you know, after you've been shooting all night every night.
And Nima had us an on-set DJ, and we had constant partying in between takes, so.
And like lots of like energy drinks, like just to keep that like energy going, so.
So you were basically, you'd been working for 5 weeks, mostly at night, and then you were given lots of energy drinks and sent into a place where there was a pool, loads of hot girls, and loads of crazy stuff going on.
Yeah,
so
pretty much. I mean,
frankly, I'm surprised you survived.
7 weeks of shooting, 5 weeks of partying.
Yeah.
So you really suffered to your art, basically, is what you're saying.
Yeah,
world smiles violin for me,
Yeah, okay. So did you draw on anything from, like, life? Have you been to crazy parties? Was there anything you just thought, God, this reminds me of that time I was at my friend's house and we burnt the place down? And
I didn't draw from a party, per se, but for character, definitely. Like, drew from things that are times in my life and also, like, friends that I have that remind me of, like, that character. But not necessarily the party. I don't
remember parties ever being that spectacular for when I was younger, but... But I think, you know, there's definitely experiences that you draw from, just, you know, little things. But we all sort of relate to our characters and play a version of ourselves in a way.
Oliver and I are actually, like, when we're on our downtime, when we're not actors, I'm kind of more of a loud, gregarious, boisterous person. Oliver's kind of the homebody who wants to go to bed at 9 p.m.
Okay.
All right, thank you. I like my sleep, so.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. I mean,
okay.